Hello to all students. I hope you are doing fine. I am Professor Masood Fuzail. Today we are going to discuss apicomplexans. As you know that apicomplexans belong to kingdom Protista. They are protozoans and they belong to a group known as sporozoa. Apicomplexans do not have cilia or flagella on their body, but they move with help of flexing. Flexing means they move with the help of some body fluid like saliva or blood. They do not have any locomotory organ. They are unicellular. The best example of apicomplexan is Plasmodium. Today we are going to discuss the life cycle of Plasmodium vivax. Life cycle of Plasmodium vivax, that is the scientific name of Plasmodium. It has different species Plasmodium, but most common is Plasmodium vivax, which cause malaria in humans. Plasmodium vivax has two hosts. The first host is human and the second host is mosquito. Which mosquito? Anopheles. First of all, I have a diagram of life cycle of Plasmodium. This is the body of human. All the body, I have taken a cross section. This body has a skin outer covering, and under the skin there is a blood capillary in which blood is flowing. This is a mosquito, and this mosquito is female Anopheles, because only female Anopheles bites human beings to suck the blood. Why only females? Why not males? Because female Anopheles produces eggs. And for the maturation of eggs, female Anopheles needs iron. And for iron, it needs hemoglobin. And for hemoglobin, it needs blood. And for blood, it is attractive towards human body, because human body contains blood, which contains hemoglobin, and hemoglobin contains iron, which is very important for the maturation of eggs of the female Anopheles. So that is why human is bitten by female Anopheles mosquito. When a person is sleeping or sitting, a female Anopheles bites a human skin with the help of its mouth parts. It pierces the skin and enters its mouth parts into the skin of the human. This skin pierces the blood capillary present under the skin. To suck the blood, it is very important that our blood has a property that it coagulates very fast. To avoid this process, female Anopheles injects little amount of saliva inside the blood capillary. This saliva contains a chemical known as anticoagulant, which prevents the coagulation or clotting of the blood so that it can easily suck the human blood. But when she injects saliva inside the blood capillaries of human, it also injects some spores of Plasmodium vivax. These spores are called sporozoites. This female was infected by Plasmodium vivax spores known as sporozoite. From where these spores had come? It is a question and the answer which we don't know. It is just like asking that which comes first, hen or its egg. Plasmodium vivax sporozoite has arrived or present in the Anopheles mosquito. We do not know exactly when this started, but anyhow, this female was infected with Plasmodium vivax spores. When she sucks the blood, it injects saliva. Along with the saliva, the sporozoites has entered in the human circulatory system or in the blood of human. From here, these are the large size of sporozoites. These sporozoites has arrived here from salivary glands of the female Anopheles. These sporophyte entering in the bloodstream of the human body reaches toward the liver. In the liver, there is a process start which is known as schizogony. Schizo means split. It means that sporozoites are going to multiply here inside the cells of the liver. This process is also known as mirogony. In the cells of the liver, these sporozoites change the shape and becomes merozoites. From there, from the liver cell, they migrate into the bloodstream again. Now these are termed as merozoites. Merozoites attack the RBC present in the blood of human. They enter the RBC with the help of apicomplexan. That is why we call these animal apicomplexan, because they have apicomplex which helps them to penetrate the living cells of different organism. When these merozoites enter the RBC, they start to multiply with the help of mitosis, and merozoites increases. After this, the cells burst like a balloon and all the new coming merozoites are released from the cells. They attack on an other red blood cell. In this way, this process continues several times, and one time it is reached when millions and billions of red blood cells in our body burst simultaneously. In this condition, symptoms of malaria are produced. Symptom of malaria is known as paroxysm, in which first of all we feel sudden shivering of the body, which lasts about 30 minutes to 40 minutes. After that, shivering stops and we get high fever due to the toxins released by the merozoites in the RBC and bursting of millions of cells. When temperature, we control the temperature with the help of some antipyretic medicines, then we feel very, very feeble, and this process can be repeated after every 48 hours. So these are the symptoms of malaria, which is also known as paroxysm. This process continues. If you take a medicine of malaria, this cycle can be stopped, but if not, it can lead to the death of the patient. Some of the merozoite released from the red blood cell attack on other red blood cell. Instead of multiplying in the red blood cell, they start a new process which is known as gametogony. During gametogony, these merozoites will change into male and female gametes. In the red blood cell, one merozoite will convert into male gametocyte or microgametocyte, while in other red blood cell, these merozoite will become female or macrogametocyte. Why are they doing so? Because they know Plasmodium is very clever. God has told him that be ready in the red blood cell, because some other mosquito is coming to suck the blood of human so that you can enter in female anopheles. Now this is a person who is infected with Plasmodium. He is sleeping or living, and some other mosquito came and start to suck the blood of this person, infected person. Now from when she sucks the blood, these male and female micro and macro gametocyte will enter the gut or digestive tract of the female anopheles. In the gut or stomach of the female anopheles, these micro and macro gametes fuse with each other. For simplicity, we can call them sperm or egg. When sperm or egg are fused with each other, zygote will form. This zygote will penetrate in the walls of stomach and becomes a zygote. After fertilization, this zygote will change into oocyst. In the oocyst, a process will start which is known as sporogony. Sporogony produces many spores, which are known as sporozoites, outside the wall of the stomach, inside the oocyst. From there, these sporocytes are transferred to salivary glands and they are ready for injection into the next healthy person. In this way, the life cycle of the Plasmodium vivax is completed into host, causing a disease known as malaria. Now this cycle can be summarized as here. Sperm and egg, for simplicity I have written sperm and egg, but actually they are micro and macro gametes, fuse with each other and form a zygote. You can see over here, male and female gametes are fusing with each other and forming a zygote with the wall of stomach. After formation, zygote starts a process known as sporogony. During process of sporogony, many sporozoites are produced. As you can see here, many sporozoites are produced here and are transferred to salivary glands. From salivary glands, these sporozoites will enter into the bloodstream of a healthy person. When sporozoites enter into the healthy person, they attack on their liver cells. In the liver cells, a process known as schizogony will start, which is also known as merogony, and many merozoites are produced. Merozoites are released from the liver cell will enter and attack on the red blood cells of the healthy person. When they attack on the red blood cell, they will multiply by mitosis and increase in number and cause the paroxysm or symptoms of malaria. And some of the merozoite will change into gametocyte, microgametocyte and macrogametocyte, which later on become sperm and egg and fuse again to form, complete the life cycle of the plasmodium. So in this way, today we have tried to understand the epicomplexan as well as life cycle of plasmodium and some symptoms of malaria. I hope you have understood it. If you do, please like it, subscribe it, share with your friends. See you in the next lecture. Bye.